sunniest summer ever recorded. We had 3 months of continuous sunshine. Crops were failing. Houses cracked, roads melted, and lakes and reservoirs were drying up.
Our family's move to Doncaster coincides with the great heat wave of 1976. England is in the grip of a drought. Forest fires break out daily. Temperatures hit 36 degrees. Water becomes scarce. The land is scorched and bleached. With the heat wave come soaring numbers of aphids. Hot on their trail, a plague of ladybirds. Huge clouds of them shimmer through the air. They cling to your hair and your clothes. And when the aphids have gone, the ladybirds starve to death. Millions of their bodies litter the streets and the countryside. This was a biblical prophecy, English style. Something even stranger happens that summer. In the midst of the heat wave, we take a family trip to the dark waters of Ladybower Reservoir in Derbyshire to see the drowned church. Building of Ladybower began in 1935. Deep in the valley, the villages of Derwent and Ashipton were demolished. Residents were ordered to leave their homes forever in the name of progress. But while the villages were destroyed, Derwent's church was left standing, a mark of respect or superstition perhaps. And during times of severe drought, Derwent's church spire would slowly re-emerge through the waters. A stone creature rising from the depths, a drowning god coming up for air. I was 8 years old. I remain haunted by this uncanny apparition.
Only the top of the church spire remained visible as the village became a lake. A long draught caused this to happen. A long draught caused this to happen.
I've heard a definition of haunting saying we are haunted by that which we cannot or cannot completely understand.
Romans in 43 AD to build a settlement at the lowest crossing of the river, a fort to divide north and south. But the Don's legacy is older than the Romans. Once the river would have been venerated as a goddess. To our pre-Roman ancestors, wells and springs were entrances to other worlds. Rivers, lakes, lochs, each had their guardians, deities, goddesses, nymphs. The Romans named their new town Danum after Danu, Celtic goddess of rivers, Hindu goddess of primordial waters. Danu, the divine creator who birthed all things into being, a hydromancer. For those with the courage to sleep by her side, in her dream palace of the well or by a spring, she may divine the future in her swirling eddies. Danu, who gave her name to the Danube, the Duna, the Dane, Danu, the Don. Danu became Danum, became Doncaster, a town built on a river that has since forgotten its river. An inconvenience. It was shunted to the far side of the town, neglected and unloved. A river I grew up never knowing. What happened to the Don, to Danu, our river goddess? What did we do to her? Was there some mysterious connection between water and the feminine? Seeking answers, I paid a visit to England's greatest living wizard, Alan Moore.
Rivers defined the landscape and how accessible it was long before we had the roads and the paths. They are the original markers of the landscape. Water is generally seen as a female element. In the tarot deck, its corresponding suit is cups, which symbolizes compassion. The male and the female energies, they are both necessary for the creation of anything, whether that be an idea or whether that be a universe. If one of them is dominating, then that's not really how it should work. That will lead to problems.